Hello guys and welcome to my channel. Today, I want to show you the method I use to find and fill out the 7 keyword boxes on KDP. As you all already know, when creating books on KDP, we have to enter some information like title and subtitle, author name, contributors, book description, book categories, and the 7 keyword boxes. Most people will spend hours trying to find the right keywords to fill out the boxes, and in doing so, they start neglecting more important stuff like book titles and subtitles. Before continuing with this video, you should know and understand that even though the 7 keyword boxes are important, they do not have the same weight as your book title and subtitle. So if you are creating your book right now, I recommend that you spend enough time crafting a good title and subtitle, and only after you are done with that should you move to the 7 keyword boxes. That being said, if you are still struggling to find good titles for your books, or want to learn more about how to do niche research on KDP, then you can watch this video right here on the cards section, where you will learn a quick and effective method to find best-selling books on Amazon. In this video, we will try to answer two main questions, so that we can learn how to find high-quality keywords. How can we know which keywords should we write in the 7 boxes? And should we be using phrases or single words? To answer the second question first, I started using a combination of both phrases and single words in the last year, and from my own experience, both of them can work well if done correctly. So to give you an example, if I were to create an animal coloring book for kids, I might include some single words like children, boy, or girl in the boxes, but I can also add some other phrases that make sense with my niche. Let's say that my keyword research showed me that a certain phrase is constantly being used by people searching on Amazon, and when I try to run a search with that phrase, I don't see a lot of competition. At that point, I will try to include that whole phrase into the 7 boxes. There is a debate about whether or not adding anything after that phrase is helpful or not, but I don't see that much of a difference. If you have any experience with this or want to share your opinion about this, leave a comment down below and tell me if you think we should add a single phrase per box, or if it's okay to also add words after that phrase. Now that we answered the second question, let's take a look at how to find words or phrases to use on the 7 boxes. There are a lot of methods to look for keywords, however. In this video, I will share with you the methods that I use to find keywords when I create KDP books. The first method that I use is going to Amazon.com and searching for the main niche that I want to target. After that, I will take a look at what the other books are using in their titles and see if there is any word or phrase that stick out, any word or phrase that is being used by multiple sellers, or any word that is related to my book niche that a client might use to search for that book. It might sound like too much work, but believe me when I say that if you take the time to carefully look for words and phrases, and compare the different results from the results page, you will inevitably find a word or phrase that is worth the effort, and that keyword might be the key to your book ranking higher or getting more impressions. The second method that I use in combination with the first method is to use synonyms. Most of the time sellers on Amazon will all use the same keywords or a few variations of that keyword, which give you a huge opportunity to look for synonyms to the keywords that you found using the first method that only a few sellers or no sellers are using. And this is great because once again, you can target words that clients are searching for that no other seller is paying attention to. Another method that you can use to find keywords for your KDP books is paying for advertisement, specifically KDP auto ad campaigns. To use the automatic ad campaign, you will need a book already created. You can either use an older book that you already have, or simply create a new book, find some keywords using the methods we discussed earlier, and run an auto ad to gather data. With an auto ad, you can see search terms that customers are using to search on Amazon. And you can also see how many impressions your ad or book got from that keyword, how many clicks your ad got, how many sales or conversions, etc. And once you have all that data, you can then create a list of the most profitable search terms that you can then use to fill the 7 keyword boxes. This method might take some time, and you will need to have some experience running ads to not lose too much money when you are just using this ad as a way to get more keywords. If you want to learn how to prepare your ad campaigns and avoid losing money, I already made a video showing you how to do that, and I also have an Excel sheet that will help you quickly prepare your ads. If you don't want to do it manually every time, you can head to my Gumroad shop. The link is in the description. There are many other ways to find good keywords that you can use when creating your KDP books, like using Google Keyword Planner, using Google Trends, using browser extensions like Helium 10, and a lot more. But that is not what matters. What you should focus on is not how many keyword tools or websites you use, but the quality of each keyword you end up using, and how relevant are your keywords to your book. You should also never try to game the system, and never try anything that might get your account in trouble. The methods I showed you today should be enough for you to start creating books that sell, books that rank high, and books that might help you achieve your passive income goals. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I hope that I helped you learn something new today. Thanks for watching.